Hello and welcome to this online concert here from St. Mary's Basilica, Krakow in Poland. On this, probably one of the newest instruments I've ever played, it was only actually dedicated a couple of weeks ago, so this is one of the first times there's been a concert on it, by Riga Organ Builders in Austria. An amazing, amazing new organ for this incredible basilica, one of the great landmarks here in Krakow in Poland and for the whole of Poland. Anyone who's come here will know this church in the central square. And normally bustling with thousands and thousands of tourists all day, I'm here to give a concert, but I thought I'd bring you an online concert, and it's amazing to have this incredible opportunity to have the place all to ourselves, because I'm here with my brother Tom, who's filming and recording and bringing you some absolutely spectacular architecture, paintings all over the place, and the whole of the place is so, so beautifully decorated. Tom will probably actually be showing you that most of the time rather than me playing this wonderful instrument. As I said, built by Riegers of Austria, 76 stops on this console. Also, we have another organ of 14 stops right at the front, which is playable on any manual of this organ. 14 stops with pedal as well. A top manual with high pressure reeds, also bells, and a big, big cornet, and then another three manuals and pedal. A hugely powerful symphonic instrument, as you will have heard in that first piece. But I'm going to bring some more gentle stuff as well. I'm going to move on to the Anistei from Faure's Requiem. And one of the requirements of the concert I'm giving here is that a third of the programme is religious music, because we are in such an amazingly beautiful religious building. In fact, Krakow is very famous for being a religious area since John Paul II, Pope John Paul, or Saint Pope John Paul II, was actually Archbishop here in Krakow before he became the first non-Italian Pope in over 450 years. And he's a great, great celebrated figure in this area. So I was asked to play a third religious music. And I thought some transcriptions from requiems and religious pieces would be the perfect thing. Faure's Anistei is the Lamb of God from the Requiem, a very beautiful, moving and poignant piece of music, which I've transcribed for organ solo. I think it works really well, all those warm solo sounds and the lux aeternum in the middle. So I hope you enjoy this. This is Anistei from Faure's Requiem. I hope you could hear the presbytery organ at the front playing the tenor line. An amazing effect in here, so I hope it comes across. And I'm going to be using the effect of the echo between the two instruments now in what is one of the most monumental pieces of organ music ever written. A lot of people have asked for this, so I thought I'd save it for somewhere quite spectacular. It's Bach's Passacaglia, or Passacaglia and Fugue in C minor. The Passacaglia is literally 21 repetitions of a ground in the pedals, and there's sort of almost variations on it all the way through. It's almost treated as if it's a theme and then 20 variations. People view it in many different ways. Some people think it should be played on one organ planum, one sort of sound all the way through, but I think it has so many opportunities to show the different colours of an instrument that I'm going to go the opposite way and do a really symphonic version, including echoes between the two instrument tuba solos up to full organ. So I hope you enjoy hearing this piece. It's absolutely incredible. If you've never heard this before, this was a great inspiration for many, many romantic composers. You can hear, it's almost like Brahms, Tchaikovsky, people like Respighi were influenced by it and transcribed it also for orchestra. It's just monumental and sounds so romantic in one way, but Baroque in another. And I think this instrument is symphonic in style, but it was built to be able to play almost any style in this amazing place. So I hope you enjoy this interpretation of it. This is Bach's Passacaglia and Fugue in C minor. It's an intense experience hearing that piece in a space like this, especially with this absolutely amazing acoustic. It seems to go on forever from up here high on the organ gallery. A brilliant, brilliant piece. As I said, more religious music, the Lacrimosa from Mozart's Requiem. Mozart wrote this in the last year of his life. In fact, it was probably the last thing he ever wrote, and he didn't quite manage to finish it. The Lacrimosa alone, he managed to write the first 8 bars, and the rest of the piece was finished by Süssmayr. There's a lot of mystery surrounding this piece. People often attribute the phrase that Mozart said, "Didn't you know I was writing this for myself," as a sort of tribute for the Requiem. It was actually commissioned secretly by a count, apparently to dedicate the death of his wife the same year it was commissioned. Many people thought the count was trying to take it so it could be passed off as one of his own pieces, but in the end, Mozart never saw it performed. But the ideas behind it have been taken and made into the piece we know today. And I thought it worked beautifully on the organ, this sort of beautiful lilting Lacrimosa, the tears falling via this chromatic sound, and then the choir coming in on this manual here. And it builds up to a huge, huge sound, really. Absolutely amazing. And while we're in this church, there's so many amazing facts surrounding it. On the hour, which is probably coming up here when we're recording, the trumpeter sounds from every 4 towers on the top of one of the big towers. He plays his trumpet watch, which has been gone since the Middle Ages, to warn of fires in the city and to check all is well around the city. And actually, one of them was actually shot by an arrow. So as he gets onto his 4th turn round, he suddenly cuts off. And this is tradition. This actually happens every hour, on the hour, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. An amazing tradition. So I'm not sure if you'll be able to hear it at all above the organ, but it's an amazing fact. So I hope you enjoy this next piece anyway. This is Mozart's Lacrimosa from the Requiem.
Thank you.
possibly slightly bigger than Mozart may have been used to if he'd have heard it finished off. But it was a great opportunity. And on this instrument, we have a big tuba on the top manual, but also a smaller tuba sonora, which is like a French horn, which you'll have heard at the end of that piece. I'm going to play something much more gentle now, Ave Maria by Gounod. Literally just an improvisation on the first prelude of the 48 Preludes and Fugues by Johann Sebastian Bach. Gounod was playing and improvising over this, and the story is that his father-in-law heard this and wrote it down, sent it to a publisher, and had it published without Gounod knowing. The original version is actually for piano, harmonium, and violin solo, and there's a counter melody on the second verse of it. Words Ave Maria were added, and the rest is history. It's a very, very famous piece, become a famous religious piece, and since we're in St. Mary's Basilica, it only seems appropriate to play an Ave Maria. And this is undoubtedly, if not the most famous, one of the most famous in the world. I'll play the melody on the pedals for the first verse of it with the original Bach parts on the manuals and then grow to a bigger sound, and also use the presbytery organ as well. So I hope you enjoy this. This is Ave Maria by Gounod. very, very beautiful and famous music, and a great way to show the wonderful, warm sounds of this instrument. I've had a wonderful time just exploring and finding out what it does, and I hope you'll be able to come and hear this in real life. I'm looking forward to giving the live recital in here. It's, as I say, a great opportunity, and so wonderful to be actually here alone in this amazing, amazing place. So I hope you enjoyed hearing it, and thank you to Tom for bringing you the wonderful sound of this instrument, but also the amazing architecture and everything in this church. There's actually almost too much to take in when you look around, but hopefully you'll be able to see a bit more from what Tom's brought you than you actually can in real life. So it's wonderful to bring that to you, and thank you so much for watching. And I want to finish with probably one of the most uplifting and joyful pieces of music. In fact, it's Mendelssohn's Italian Symphony, the first movement, and Mendelssohn himself described it, that he was writing, one of the jolliest pieces he'd ever written. And I think we can all agree that it definitely is. He was on a tour at the same time, really. It was the time when he wrote Fingal's Cave and the Scottish Symphony, when he was going around Britain. He also went around Europe as well, and in Rome he began the Italian Symphony, and he completed it when he got home, and it was actually premiered in London in the 1830s, and it's become one of the most famous orchestral pieces, very happy, joyful and lively. And so I thought I'd do an organ transcription to show the sort of symphonic character of this instrument. It's in A major, it's bright, happy, and almost Italian in many ways. It's got a tarantella sort of feel about it. Very famous for these repetitive rhythms and sort of these very driving rhythms, which Mendelssohn is always famous for. But he always brings drama with his amazing key changes. So I hope you enjoy this to finish with today. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you to Tom Filming, and thank you to everyone here at St. Mary's for allowing us to come and film and record and bring this to you today. So, to finish with today, the Italian Symphony, first movement by Mendelssohn.